वीडियोस देखने के लिए सब्सक्राइब करें जनसत्ता.com, बेल आइकन दबा कर पाएं लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशंस।
Emergency, but India today is in a state of undeclared emergency. But the government has miscalculated. There is a fundamental difference between cowardice and courage. The coward is brave only when armed with power and authority. The truly courageous can fight even when unarmed. Do not forget this. Do not forget this when you tell the authorities in Ghaziabad to clear the protest site overnight with the help of the police and the bureaucracy. You are not being courageous. You're a coward wielding power. The truly brave came in droves from villages wielding nothing but the belief that their cause is just. They were propelled by the spontaneous tears of their leader, not by the force of their water cannons. Do not forget this when you block the roads and cut the internet off in 17 of Haryana's districts. You are not being brave. You are a coward wielding power. The state of Haryana gives 10% of India's air force and contributes to 11% of the total strength of the Indian Navy. Its people can neither be termed anti-national, nor terrorists, nor gaddars. Do not forget this. When a peaceful 60-day movement is insidiously hijacked, and then you slap FIRs on Punjab's farmers, you are not being courageous. You're a coward wielding power. Bhagel Singh and Jassa Singh Ahluwalia, leading their missiles, captured Delhi way back in 1783 from the Mughals. Their descendants do not lead a lesson in courage from those who captured Delhi only in 2014. In the 125th year of Subhash Chandra Bose's birth, the central government has made every attempt to hijack Netaji's legacy and weave it into their own fake, narrow narrative of courage. But this nation needs to know that Netaji had two clarion calls, both embodiments of his courage and his spirit. One was the salutation, Jai Hind. Today, this government has replaced this national greeting with a narrow religious chant that it uses as a war cry to heckle, to bully, and to always, always remind the minority about who's in charge. Netaji's second call was Dilli Chalo. Chalo Dilli. This government falls over itself to pay lip service to Netaji. But in truth, you block the borders in Singhu, in Ghazipur, in Tikri with walls and spikes for all those who actually want to come to Delhi to tell you that much like Subhash Chandra Bose, they too will not accept any halfway house. Netaji told us never to lose faith in the destiny of India, and it is not India's destiny to be ruled by cowards. The time has come for us
Please
all to show courage.
Please conclude.
Girte hai sheh sawar maidan-e-jang mein, wo tifl kya gire jo ghutno ke bal chale? Repeal or nothing. Thank you.